Hello friends, as promised, today I am making a new video on a different question. So today's question is, what is tractor PTO and what is the direction of rotation of PTO? So as you can see in this figure that this is a tractor where this rotavator is being connected, and this rotavator is being connected through this universal joint shaft to this tractor PTO. There will be one output shaft which will be coming out of this particular housing from back of a tractor. You might have seen in tractor already, and that shaft is connected to this implement through this particular universal joint shaft. So we will see the definition. So this is about me. So the answer of first part, that is, what is PTO? So PTO, the full form of PTO is power takeoff. So a tractor power takeoff, that is PTO, is used to transmit rotary power from a tractor to an implement. So basically, as you can see in this particular photograph, this is the output shaft about which I was talking. So there are splines made on this particular shaft. So in this shaft there will be 6 splines, which is the standard for 540 PTO RPM. There will be splines where more than 6 number of splines. There will be PTO shaft where more than 6 number of splines will be used. So I'm going to make a detailed, very detailed conceptual videos on tractor PTO. So stay tuned, that will come later. So here for this, for the scope of this video, so this is the output shaft from where the universal joint shaft will be connected and the power will be transmitted to an implement. So this shaft will rotate in a particular direction. So this will have rotary power, and this rotary power will be transmitted to an implements like rotavator or sesar, etc. So a tractor PTO is used to transmit rotary power from a tractor to an implement. So why this is required? Because transmission through PTO is the most efficient and economical method of transmitting power from an agricultural tractor to an agricultural implement. You see, friends, there are different points from where power can be taken from a tractor. You can attach a cultivator on an MB plow to a tractor through 3-point linkage. So that is also one of the mechanism of taking power from a tractor. But those are not that much efficient. So there are power losses associated with those type of drives. But PTO shaft, when you take drive from PTO, that is the most efficient method of taking power from a tractor. So least power loss will happen if you take a drive from a tractor PTO. So tractor PTO is being used to take drive for a variety of agricultural operations such as rotavator, threshers, irrigation pumps, straw reapers, sprayers, post hole diggers, water pumps and generators, etc. I hope that you already are aware of all these implements. If not, then you can search on Google about these things. The most common and standard speed available for a tractor PTO is 540 RPM. That is the rotational speed of this particular shaft is around 540. That is a standard which is being used globally. Everywhere in all countries. So if a tractor manufacturer is providing a tractor PTO, then definitely 540 will be there. But there might be cases where other than 540 there are other speeds also given by the manufacturers. So along with 540 RPM, few other commonly available PTO speeds are 540E, where E stands for economical. When I say economical, it means that fuel consumption is least. So I will talk about this later in a separate video. For 540, the RPM will be around 750. Then in some cases, there might be reverse speeds available or reverse PTOs available. Then not in India, but in some foreign countries, this 1000 RPM is also available. Now, how this PTO is being connected to an implement? So that you can see in this particular figure. So this is a tractor side where this PTO, this is a PTO output shaft, this one. Now this is a shaft, universal joint shaft, about which I was talking. So this particular thing is coming on the PTO output shaft, and then this is a telescopic shaft, which means that its length can be increased or decreased according to the requirement. And then the other universal joint, this thing is being connected to implement. So similar splines and shaft will be made on implement also, like rotavator and thresher and all other implements, which is being connected to PTO. And here it will be connected to PTO. So this will be an implement input drive line. So this side will be tractor, this side will be implement. So tractor power will be transmitted to implement. Okay, so this is what PTO is. So this is a definition which can be used by you. Now coming to the second answer of second part, what is the direction of rotation of PTO? So when this is the basic answer, when we look from the rear side of a tractor, a PTO shaft will always rotate in clockwise direction. Remember this thing, a PTO shaft will always rotate in clockwise direction if you look from a back end of a tractor or rear of a tractor. Now, why is it so? So for this, you need to understand a little bit about engine and how power flows happen to a tractor PTO. So as we can see here, engine output from flywheel will always be in anti-clockwise direction. Remember this friend, this is a global standard. Whenever engine is being designed, an engine output will be taken from flywheel, and the direction of rotation of engine output shaft will always be in anti-clockwise direction. You take any engine, that direction of rotation of engine will always be in anti-clockwise direction. This also might be asked in any interview or Viva or anywhere. So just remember this thing also. Now for PTO output, what we do is we usually take one gear reduction, and then power flow will happen to PTO output shaft. So this is a basic standard tractor diesel engine which you can see over here, and this is a flywheel. You can see there are these gears which are mounted on the flywheels. These are called timing gears. I'm not going to explain to you timing gears. Just search about that or read about what timing gears are used for. Okay, and just let me know in the comment section. So this is how this is a flywheel, and basically transmission clutch will be attached to this particular flywheel. So, and this flywheel, the direction of rotation of this flywheel will be in anti-clockwise direction. So this always be in anti-clockwise direction, and a PTO shaft will be directly connected to an engine. Now you can see the basic layout of a single speed tractor which I have made over here. So this is the PTO input shaft. Now this input shaft will directly be connected to tractor engine. So if engine flywheel is rotating, or engine output shaft is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, it means that this shaft is also rotating in counterclockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Now this cross things, these four cross things are basically bearings. So as you might be knowing that a single shaft will be supported by at least two bearings. So this input shaft will be at two bearings, and this output shaft also will be at two bearings. And now this in between this is a gear reduction. So normally the RPM of rated RPM of an engine is normally in the range of 2000 to 2200. So engine will rotate at 2000 to 2200 RPM, and then one gear reduction will be used, and then output of PTO will be in the range of 540 RPM. Okay, so 540 is a standard. So this is how drive is being taken. So as you might be aware that in a gear reduction, if the first gear is rotating in counterclockwise direction, then second will rotate in clockwise direction, the opposite of the first gear. So the output shaft will automatically rotate in clockwise direction. So all if you look from rear side of a tractor, friends, always tractor PTO will rotate in clockwise direction, and engine will always rotate in anti-clockwise direction if you look from flywheel side. So this is the reason why PTO's direction of rotation will always be clockwise. Okay. Now for detailed PTO, I will make a separate video. Now this is a single speed PTO. If it is single speed PTO, then it will always be 540 RPM PTO. Now if there are other speeds available, then along with 540, there will be other gears might be put in the might be there in the PTO section. But even though other gears are there, 540 will always be there because it is a statutory requirement, regulatory requirement, and this is the basic standard followed globally. So this always be there. Okay. So I hope you understood the concept why direction of PTO rotation is always in clockwise direction when looking from back of a tractor. Okay. So thank you very much for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy, and tomorrow again I will take one other question and I will answer that question. Thank you very much.